Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is tricarboxylic acid cycle. It is a very important question for university examination. It is a long answer question frequently asked in university or college examination. Okay. Coming to the introduction, this cycle was completely described by Sir Hans Krebs. In 1937 and got Nobel Prize in 1953. That's why the another name of this cycle is Krebs cycle. This tricyclic acid, tricarboxylic acid, was later known by the name citric acid. It is due to the discoverer, that is Oxton. Later in 1948, Oxton described that the tricarboxylic acid described by the Hans Krebs is citric acid. That's why the another name for this cycle is citric acid cycle. TCA cycle, citric acid cycle, Krebs cycle, or metabolic traffic circle. As number of pathways or number of intermediates from this Krebs cycle are important metabolic intermediate in other pathways. That's why it is also known as metabolic traffic circle. Now coming to the significance of this pathway. This pathway occurs in the mitochondria. Now coming to the significance, it is a final common oxidative pathway. Pathway for conversion into carbon dioxide. It is a final common oxidative pathway for oxidation of all foodstuffs, carbohydrate, protein, fat. Okay. Second important point, it gives reducing equivalents, that is NADH, FADH2. There is synthesis of ATP, one substrate level phosphorylation reaction, GTP, which ultimately converted into ATP. Oxaloacetate acts as a catalyst in this pathway. It is condenses with citrate, then this acetyl CoA, it is condenses with acetyl CoA converted into citrate, and again through all reaction it is again regenerated. That's why it is known as catalyst. And one sentence is there, that is fat is burned on the weak of carbohydrate. It is fat is burned on weak of carbohydrate. Here weak is oxaloacetate, which is generated from carbohydrate, from pyruvate, by pyruvate carboxylase reaction. So fat is burned on the weak of carbohydrate. For burning of fat is ultimately converted into acetyl coenzyme A. And for oxidation of acetyl coenzyme A, oxaloacetate is required. That's why it is known as fat is burned on the weak of carbohydrate. And excess of fat, this excess of carbohydrate, this carbohydrate is converted into fat. But reversal is not possible because of irreversible reaction catalyzed by pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. This is important. This pathway is important in synthesis of non-essential amino acids. It is important in the synthesis of heme, porphyrins. It is important in the synthesis of purines and pyrimidines. Heme, succinyl coenzyme A plus glycine is an initial substrate for heme synthesis. It is important in the synthesis of aspartate from oxaloacetate, which is important in purine and pyrimidine synthesis. It provides the intermediates of number of metabolic pathways. And the intermediates of this TCA cycle also act as a regulatory factors in number of pathways. So this is significance of this TCA cycle, a Krebs cycle. Now coming to the steps. It has eight important steps in the mitochondrial matrix. How many steps? Eight important steps catalyzed by eight important enzymes. This is the first reaction in which this acetyl coenzyme A condenses with oxaloacetate. This is a four carbon compound, this is two carbon compound, to give a six carbon compound, that is tricarboxylic acid citrate, with the help of enzyme citrate synthase. In the next reaction, this citrate is isomerized into isocitrate. It is a two-step reaction in which citrate is converted into cis aconitate. And this cis aconitate is converted into isocitrate by the process of dehydration and rehydration. Dehydration, removal of water molecule, and addition of water molecule. It is converted into isocitrate. There is shifting of OH group from one carbon to another. That's why it is known as isomerization reaction. Citrate is converted into isocitrate. Then isocitrate is converted into oxalosuccinate. It is a two-step reaction in which isocitrate is converted into oxalosuccinate, which is converted into alpha-ketoglutarate. There is production of NADH here. From NAD. And from oxalosuccinate, by spontaneous decarboxylation, there is formation of alpha-ketoglutarate. So this is oxidative decarboxylation, conversion of isocitrate to alpha-ketoglutarate with the help of isocitrate dehydrogenase. Oxidative decarboxylation. Then alpha-ketoglutarate again undergoes oxidative decarboxylation to give NADH. There is liberation of one molecule of CO2. Coenzyme A is added here. Okay. So, two CO2, they are removed. Two carbon from acetyl coenzyme A removed as CO2. One in the step catalyzed by isocitrate dehydrogenase and another in the step catalyzed by alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. This is the first site for NADH production. This is the second site for NADH production. This is a multi-enzyme complex. It is a multi-enzyme complex. It is composed of this alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, composed of three enzymes and five coenzymes. It is an important MCQ. Three enzymes and five coenzymes. Five coenzymes are TPP, FAD, NAD, lipoic acid, and coenzyme A. These are the five coenzymes. It is an important MCQ. It is similar to that of pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. This alpha-ketoglutarate is converted into succinyl coenzyme A by oxidative decarboxylation catalyzed by alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Then succinyl coenzyme A is converted into succinate with the help in this reaction. This GDP is converted into GTP, which ultimately gives ATP. This is a high energy compound. The coenzyme, this succinyl coenzyme A, it is a high energy compound, and from this compound there is direct production of ATP. That's why it is known as substrate level phosphorylation by succinate thiokinase. Substrate level phosphorylation, synthesis of ATP without undergoing electron transport chain, is known as substrate level phosphorylation. Then here succinate is converted into fumarate by succinate dehydrogenase. FAD is converted into FADH2. Then fumarase, by addition of water molecule, it is converted into malate. And again, malate is converted into oxaloacetate by malate dehydrogenase. In this, NAD is converted into NADH. And oxaloacetate is regenerated. So oxaloacetate is known as catalyst in the Krebs cycle because it enters in the reaction and remains as it is at the end. That's why it is known as catalyst oxaloacetate. It is a weak of carbohydrate which is required for burning of fat, burning of acetyl coenzyme A. Two carbon from acetyl CoA liberated as CO2, one in the isocitrate dehydrogenase reaction and another in alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase reaction. three sites for NADH production. First, this is isocitrate dehydrogenase. First, second alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Third one is the malate dehydrogenase. Three NADH production. One FADH2 production by succinate dehydrogenase. And one ATP production by substrate level phosphorylation. Okay, so coming to the energetics of this pathway, 3 NADH production will give 2.5 is equal to 7.5 ATPs. 1 FADH2 will give 1.5 ATP and 1 substrate level phosphorylation will give 1 ATP. Total is 10. Per turn of acetyl coenzyme A, you will get 10 ATPs. For glucose, you will get 20 ATPs. From glucose, you will get 2 pyruvate, then 2 acetyl coenzyme A and 20 ATPs from one molecule of glucose by TCA cycle. But per turn of acetyl coenzyme A will give 10 ATPs. This is the energetic of TCA cycle. Then some inhibitors are there. Inhibitors of TCA cycle. It is a very, very important MCQ. Inhibitors of TCA cycle. The mnemonic. There is one important and easy mnemonic to remember this TCA cycle, that is citrate is Krebs starting substrate for making oxaloacetate. This is a mnemonic to remember intermediates of TCA cycle. Citrate, isocitrate, ketoglutarate, succinyl coenzyme A, succinate, fumarate, malate, oxaloacetate. It is a mnemonic to remember intermediates of TCA cycle. Now, inhibitors of TCA cycle, one important mnemonic is there to remember the inhibitors of TCA cycle, that is FAMAKS, FAMAX, FAMAKS. Okay, this is aconitase, ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, succinate dehydrogenase. These are the enzymes. These are inhibitor. Aconitase, it is inhibited by fluoroacetate. Then alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase inhibited by arsenite. And succinate dehydrogenase inhibited by malonate. This is a important MCQ, malonate. Important, very, very important MCQ. Succinate dehydrogenase is inhibited by malonate. These are the inhibitors. This is mnemonic to remember TCA cycle. This is mnemonic to remember inhibitors of TCA cycle. Now coming to the regulation. Regulation is important and it is dependent on availability of the substrate. Regulation of TCA cycle is important in the important. It is first by the availability of substrate. Availability of substrate. Okay, ADP is important regulator. Availability of ADP is important. ADP will stimulate the pathway. It is regulated by citrate synthase, isocitrate dehydrogenase and alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. These are the three important enzymes which are allosterically regulated by different inhibitors. The important role of this pathway is the production of ATP. So ATP, if ATPs are available, ATP will inhibit this pathway. If NADH is available, NADH will inhibit this pathway. If ADP is available, it will stimulate the pathway. And the substrates, for example, succinyl coenzyme A will inhibit alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. The acetyl coenzyme A will inhibit pyruvate dehydrogenase. In this way, this pathway is regulated. This is the regulation of TCA cycle. Now coming to the amphibolic role of TCA cycle. It is important, amphibolic. Amphibolic role of TCA cycle means this cycle is anabolic as well as catabolic. That is known as amphibolic role of TCA cycle. Anabolic as well as catabolic. Okay. So catabolic role of TCA cycle we already seen. This acetyl coenzyme A is converted catabolic. Catabolic means this acetyl coenzyme A will give you two molecule of CO2. This is a catabolic role. All foodstuffs, they are oxidized into CO2 by this pathway. In anabolic role, this pathway, for example, this oxaloacetate, in anabolism, amphibolic role means catabolic as well as anabolic. This oxaloacetate, it is converted into aspartate. And this aspartate is important in the synthesis of purines and pyrimidines. This is the anabolic role. Then this citrate, it is an important source of acetyl coenzyme A in cytosol. In cytosol, the citrate is an important source of acetyl coenzyme A, which is required for fatty acid synthesis, cholesterol synthesis. This is the second. Then this alpha-ketoglutarate, it will give you glutamate. It will give you GABA. Gamma amino butyric acid, glutamate and GABA. In succinyl coenzyme A, it is important in the synthesis of heme. It is important in the synthesis of porphyrin, heme, succinyl coenzyme A. Also, it is important in ketolysis. Heme synthesis, ketolysis. So, this is important anabolic role of this TCA cycle. Synthesis of aspartate, synthesis of purines, pyrimidines, synthesis of non-essential amino acids, synthesis of fatty acid and cholesterol from acetyl coenzyme in the cytosol via the citrate. Then it will give you glutamate, gamma amino butyric acid, succinyl coenzyme A will give you heme. It is important in ketolysis. So this is anabolic role of TCA cycle. Now coming to the important short note, that is anaphylaretic reactions of the TCA cycle. What do you mean by anaphylaretic reaction of the TCA cycle? Anaphylarosis means the reaction which replenishes the intermediates of TCA cycle is known as anaphylaretic reaction. Anaphylaretic reaction. It is an important short note. Okay. The first anaphylaretic reaction is formation of oxaloacetate from pyruvate by pyruvate carboxylase. Carboxylase required ABC, ATP, biotin and CO2 is required. Pyruvate is converted into oxaloacetate by pyruvate carboxylase. The reaction which replenishes the stores or the intermediates of TCA cycle are known as anaphylaretic reaction. So this is oxaloacetate. It is the intermediate of TCA cycle. Second important is this glutamate is converted into alpha-ketoglutarate by transamination and deamination. Glutamate is converted into alpha-ketoglutarate. Then important amino acids, for example, this glutamate, then arginine, proline, arginine, proline, histidine. This amino acid will give you alpha-ketoglutarate. Then third, succinyl coenzyme A. Propionyl coenzyme A will give you succinyl coenzyme A. And it is also from valine, methionine, isoleucine, and threonine you will get succinyl coenzyme A. Then tyrosine phenylalanine will give you fumarate. Urea cycle also gives you fumarate. Then synthesis of malate from pyruvate by the malic enzyme is an example of anaphylaretic reaction. Pyruvate is converted into malate by malic enzyme. This is a NADPH dependent reaction. And sixth one is the conversion of aspartate to oxaloacetate. It is important by transamination reaction. Aspartate is converted into oxaloacetate. So these are the six important anaphylaretic reaction which fills up the intermediates of TCA cycle. Pyruvate is converted into oxaloacetate, glutamate, and these amino acids are converted into alpha-ketoglutarate. Propionyl coenzyme A, valine, methionine, isoleucine, threonine will give succinyl coenzyme A. Glucogenic amino acid, urea cycle will give you fumarate. This pyruvate is converted into malate by malic enzymes, and aspartate is converted into oxaloacetate by transamination reaction. This is important short note, so anaphylaretic reactions of TCA cycle. Summarizing the TCA cycle, it is an important metabolic pathway. It is common oxidative pathway for all foodstuff. Oxaloacetate in this pathway act as a catalyst. It is regenerated. Oxaloacetate is required for the burning of acetyl coenzyme A. That's why sentence is there. Fat is burned on the weak of carbohydrate. There are three inhibitors of TCA cycle, that is malonate, arsenite, fluoroacetate, arsenite and malonate. These are the three inhibitors of TCA cycle. So this is all about TCA cycle. Keep watching, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.